everybody. I'm doing what I usually will not do, and that's sitting in my car and making a video for YouTube. But I just want to say thank you for tuning in. Remember to like and subscribe. I am actually sitting in front of the beauty salon where my daughter is getting a facial for her wedding, and I was just thinking, you know, when you fly and you are in an airplane, and in the beginning before you fly, they would say, they will give you all the flying information, the safety rules, and they would say before you put on somebody else's mask, if there's pressure in the cabinet, you must put on your mask first. And that remind me of the scripture in Mark 12 verse 31 that says, the second is this: love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than this. You need to love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind. And then you need to love your neighbor as yourself. And I've realized that many people, we are falling apart and we are going through life so hard because of what's happening around us. And we are trying to save everybody else and we're trying to help everybody else. But we neglect ourselves. And I'm not here to promote, you know, self whatever. I'm just saying, it's like in the airplane, if you're not going to put on your mask first and make sure that you are okay, how can you help somebody else? How can you give of yourself to other people if you are falling apart? And I'm doing what I usually would not do. Like I said in the beginning, I'm sitting in front of the salon because my daughter's getting married, and I'm not going in because I have like a little bit of a cold and I don't want to put on the mask. So for my safety and of course everybody else's safety, I'm sitting in the car. So I decided to do this video today to tell you, have you ever thought of how you treat people? And maybe you've treated somebody bad or you've said something to somebody, and it wasn't really because of the person, but it was because of something on the inside of you that you haven't dealt with. Because many people, they live in shame and guilt, unforgiveness and bitterness, and that is just what is streaming from them. But if you don't come to the place where you say, you know what, yes, I might not be all that and a bag of chips, and you can add a Coke to it if you want to, I might not be all that, but you know what, God created me. God created you for a time such as this, for a time to shine. And He has placed greatness on the inside of you. And if you're not going to make peace with who you are and what God has created you to be, and if you're going to carry shame and guilt and things of the past with you, you're always going to have that you're not worthy. You're not worthy to make impact. You're not worthy to talk to somebody, to speak to somebody, to disciple somebody. But if you come to a place where you make peace within yourself, you say, you know what? I accept me for who I am and for who God created me. Remember, Refinement with Tasha is growth. We are all about growth. And you've never arrived. And that's why it's important that you know that in life, you cannot stagnate where you are at. You need to grow. And if you're going to be in the place where you're just going to be satisfied with your hurt, your shame, your guilt, your bitterness, your unforgiveness, and whatever else, and maybe it is you don't accept yourself because you don't have a beautiful nose or you don't have a beautiful face according to you, but you know what, God made you fearfully and wonderfully. And you come to a place where you accept yourself and say, Lord, I accept myself for who you created me. I accept myself for what you place on the inside of me. Yes, Lord, I want to grow. I want to be refined. I want to become a better person. But that's going to take time. And that's going to be every day of your life you need to grow. But for now, Lord, I will love me the way you created me. Do you know when you come to that place of self-acceptance and self-love? Now, I don't mean it in a selfish way, because there's a lot of nonsense going out there. You need to love yourself and you need to do this. Yes, you love yourself so that you can love others. Because if you come to the place where you love yourself so that you can love others.
Sorry, I didn't quite catch that. Could you repeat it?
Siri said she didn't catch that, so we don't care about her right now. But if you come to the place where you come to that place of acceptance and you say, Lord, you know what? Yes, I've made mistakes. Yes, I've been rejected. I've been hurt. But I choose to accept myself to become better, become happier, not only in me, but in you. And I've realized I want to draw what you've placed in me to the outside so that I don't live from the outside to the inside, but that I live from the inside to the outside. If you come to that place of acceptance and accept who you are in Christ and who He is in you, then you can say, Lord, if you can use anything, use me. Heal my heart. Not only heal it, but make it whole. So that I can touch the lives of others. Because you need to take care of yourself. I said it in Leadership Wednesday, for a few years I've been struggling with my chest, breathing. But I've become so used to it that it became part of my norm. And one day, last week my dad said, my husband said, I think you need to go to the doctor. Just for a checkup. And the doctor put me on some medication. Now, I hate medication. If you know me, I hate medicine. I forget to drink it and everything. And suddenly I started to use a pump and I started to use medication. And I realized, I can breathe. I don't feel this tired anymore. I'm actually excited to wake up in the morning. Like one morning I was like awake 4 o'clock and I usually get up 10 to 5. But I was like 4 o'clock and I was ready for the day. And I was ready again after lockdown to go to the office. And I was excited. And then I realized, you know, I've been giving out so much to other people that I've neglected myself. And now that I'm actually taking care of myself, I'm even more excited to help other people. And that's what I want to say today to you. Get yourself sorted out. Deal with you. Work through your issues. Get your junk out of your trunk, if I can say it like that. Come to the place where you say, you know what? This is why I reacted like this. This is why I'm doing this. This is why I'm doing that. And I don't need to be like that. I need to be, say, Lord, here I am. Heal my heart. Heal my soul. Heal my emotions, because I want to have a pure heart, a clear conscience, a steadfast spirit, and a sincere faith, and a sound mind. That's my prayer every day. And then I will pray, I'm healed, delivered, set free, protected by the blood of Jesus. And that is what I pray every single day over my life. Because I want to be better and I want to be whole so I can touch and love other people the way God wants me to love them. Because remember a few episodes back, I said you can do only to people what you want people to do to you. And that's why it's important today on Refine with Tasha that you come to a place that you go sit and you search your heart and you search your soul and say, Lord, where do I need to grow? Where do I need to bring change in me? I haven't arrived yet. But I need you to sit and just think about it. Think on the goodness of God in your life. And that God saved you and created you to be refined, of course, so that you can be an impact maker, a world changer, a planet shaker. Today, I know I'm in my car in front of the salon, like I said. And probably not a good video, but you know what? I kept my sunglasses. I do have makeup on, though, you can see. But I've kept my sunglasses on because, as you see, the sun is just all over. But in this, I just want to say to you today, God loves you. He has chosen you for a time such as this to make impact. Get yourself healed, delivered, set free, protected. Come to the place where you acknowledge where you need growth, where you put on your mask before you help somebody else. Because if you are taken care of and you are dealt with, you will have the courage, the confidence to help other people. Remember, refinement is quality. God bless you. Till next time, like and subscribe. God bless you.